The following presentation is for entertainment and educational purposes only. Reactions to actual individuals are purely coincidental and no way, shape, or form meant to harm. In the arms of the
angel. Hi there. I'm Candace Owens. And right now in America, there's a white person suffering.
You need to take off the sign.
In the last couple of years, the Biden administration, along with the Obama administration, have single-handedly eradicated more American men than Jada Pinkett Smith and RuPaul's Drag Race. That is why I am sponsoring White Lives Matter More.
Black lives may matter, but white lives matter more. With just a small donation of $100,000 or more, you will help grassroots community organizations. In addition to funding the next white young leaders of America.
WLMM. White lives matter more.
They really do.
Advisory. All donations are not tax deductible. Nor are they exclusively for the White Lives Matter More movement. Initially, some donations will be allocated to the Candace Owens Unemployment Fund.
Waiting. I'm hoping that the wait will be well worth it. So, as I like to say, if this is your first time coming to this channel, if it is your 100th time coming to this channel, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and also turn those notifications on, because whenever I go live, whenever I upload a video, you will be the first to get that notification. Don't be the last in the know. You need to be the first in the know. So, yes. If this is your first time here, get a chance to check out the vibes, watch some old vids, you know, get a feel for what I do here, because what I do here is I do a little bit of pop culture, I do a little vlogging, a little podcasting, and some sketch every once in a while, as you probably saw in the intro. So yeah, check out the vibes, because there's going to be a lot changing around here. But before we get into the vibes of everything, what I like to do, and how I like to start all of my episodes off with, is I like to start it off with a little snack. Honey, and I advise that you do the same thing. Get you a snack, get you something to munch on, someone to munch on, whatever floats your boat, honey. You know, we do it all over here. And sit back and relax, because yes, I have a story to tell. So if you know me well, you already know what I'm going to be munching on. I am going to be munching on my very own snow cone. Yeah, I have my actual own snow cone machine, and it makes it so convenient because I can just make these right off the whiff in the comfort of my own home. So yeah, I'm going to be having a completely sober time with you guys. Because none of these have alcohol. These are actually all organic. So, yeah. We're going organic tonight. And we're going completely sober. Completely sober. Everything that's going on with me, I took a step back because I had a lot going on. I experienced some personal tragedies as far as, you know, loved ones passing on. And yeah, overall, I have been on this discovery for self. As everyone knows, I have struggled with self-esteem issues for the longest. So, it's been a year since I left you. And I must say, life has been lifing. I was recently officially diagnosed with having severe gender dysphoria by my psychiatrist. What that means for some of you is that having severe gender dysphoria can affect someone like it has affected me, to the point where I can have everything set out for me, everything ready for me to take the stage. I'm just giving this like a scenario or an example. And all of a sudden, I notice I have a 5 o'clock shadow. All of a sudden, I notice that my tuck is unraveling. These are just the psychological things that happens when you have severe gender dysphoria. And these things have been happening for me for years, but it's really hit harder this past year. And I'm not using that as just an excuse, because I've been going through, you know, several other things that I'm probably not gonna disclose. But I'm gonna be vulnerable and I'm disclosing the gender dysphoria.
Listen here, I'm not about to play with y'all. To save y'all the lecture of me telling you guys the long version and me, myself, the self-pity, I'm gonna make it really easy for you. A couple years ago, I pretty much broke it down in a short on how the gender dysphoria affects me. At this time, I did not know I had severe gender dysphoria, but this is exactly how it feels for someone that has severe gender dysphoria.
That some of you bitches that are in your 20s and your 30s and you think that, oh, that's old lady problems. That's go to bed flawless, wash face, and you wake up, hair all over the face, and you got trayed in the bedroom, honey, and you got a full motherfucking beard all on your face, honey, that was not there when you went to bed last night. It will be like a horror scene from MTV's Teen Wolf. When you wake up and you look in the mirror and you realize that the continents that pull you through your 20s and 30s is no longer working. Your hands are becoming a little bit more harder. Your face is becoming a little bit more tougher. And before you know it, you become Ving Rhames and Holiday Heart.
Okay, baby. Bye.
So, yes, it has affected me in ways that I can't even begin to have a whole conversation about, because it's a serious issue. It's a serious issue because of the fact that I've realized that I've had somewhat of gender dysphoria all my life, but the severity of it since I've gotten older is quite complex. You know, as a trans woman and a black trans woman dealing with facial hair growth, it is something I would not wish on my worst enemy. Actually, I think I would wish that on Candace Owens or Nashawn, you know. I'll take that back. Basically, it's hell. It's not comfortable. You may think it's as easy as shaving, but see, here's the thing about it. When the intensity of it, and see, I take hormones, but I still have testosterone. And that testosterone, honey, is no joke, because I can shave. Honey, I have my own laser. I have the at-home laser. It's called You Like. But that's just how serious it is. And I get electrolysis. And I still grow hair. And it's, yeah. And sometimes I break out from, you know, ingrown hairs and things of that nature. So that is a serious issue. And when it comes to me filming, there had been times, literally there had been times where I have been ready to film. I have the outfit out and everything. And I look in the mirror and I see the 5 o'clock shadow literally starting to come in right then and there. That's how it is. I think as a trans, as a black trans woman, we have it the worst when it comes to that. Because see, here's the thing about electrolysis. Electrolysis is permanent. However, the way that electrolysis works, it goes down to basically eradicate, destroy the hair follicle. But when you're African American, honey, your hair doesn't go straight up. It grows kind of like in a curl sometimes because of that, you know, having that tight curly hair, that tight ethnic kinky hair, you know. So therefore, you're not going to get a straight line. So therefore, you're going to have more electrolysis sessions. And trust me, I know electrolysis is permanent, and I have the laser here, but honey, going to electrolysis, like the few times that I've gone, that is so traumatic. It's so traumatic because of the fact that there's not enough numbing cream, there's not enough pain creams, there's not enough drugs that I can take to numb myself for that. And I think this was more frustrating is the fact that I know African American trans girls that have been going for electrolysis for 4 years now, and they've only have like 30% of their hair done. That's depressing. That's incredibly depressing. So yeah, the gender dysphoria, I've been dealing with that. And I've been dealing with the whole fact of us living in America now, living in an anti-trans society, because if you haven't noticed, you know, the far radical right, they're coming after us, and they're coming hard. Okay, that came out really wrong. That really did, because I did not mean for it to come out like that. No, you know what I mean, honey. The conservatives are really coming at the trans. And it's very frustrating because of the fact that, yes, I'm not a trans youth, so I'm not directly affected by that. But I was a trans youth at one time. And to be a trans youth and to deal with gender dysphoria, oh, honey, you are pretty much toying with, you know, that child having suicide. And I don't think that the people that are trying to push this anti-transness understand that. And I've said this so many times before to the J.K. Rowlands, the Candace Annoyans, is that they don't understand exactly the type of harm that they're causing to our community. But I think the person that I'm really disappointed with the very, very most, and I hate to say this because I do admire some of her videos and I do admire some of her stances, but I'm very disappointed with Blair White. Because she goes so hard at the trans girls. I mean, you're gonna
be on. Jesus. I thought it was about pride, good emotions.
Do not engage with the police, don't engage with
them. Look how crazy this person is. Yes, this is a fan of mine, get away from me. Now you're just being a stalker, sir. Now you're just stalking. Stalker, no stalking.
Causing problems.
How am I causing problems?
When I'm antagonizing people.
The non-binary cast member on SNL, it was the most embarrassing thing I've ever seen. It was like just some fat white lady with a men's basketball hat on or something.
What? I don't understand. what the logic behind it. Maybe there's none. It's just I said it therefore, and that's what Democrats do.
What's white? So it's the white guilt, how you get a minority point, which
right.
It's the white guilt stuff I think cannot be understood.
Just because I'm fat, that doesn't invalidate the things that I say.
She died.
You ready to get supersized?
She died too.
Today I've got the big Fruit Loop.
He's dead.
Join me on my Fat Positive radio show.
Which didn't last long because she died.
That you can have so much energy to go for your own community, for the conservatives, when it's all said and done, they're not going to look at you and pat you on the back and say, oh, you're one of the good ones. They've secretly been trying to get rid of you too. So I don't know what you think this is going to, how this is going to end, darling, but ciao. You know, another thing too that has had me out for the last year, and I've been discovering, is that a lot of people are very disingenuous. Very disingenuous. You know, a lot of you guys know I've had my struggles and my adventures with dating men and just relationships as it is, period. And this year has not been any different. But if anything, I've noticed one thing. I've noticed the men have become more feminine, especially here in California. You know, it's kind of like, you know, no shade, all tea. Honey, it definitely plays a part of my gender dysphoria, because I definitely be feeling like I'm the goddamn man in the relationship with the man. You know, I gotta pay for the Uber. I gotta come pick you up. You know, I mean, where is the... Men are very comfortable with women paying for their Uber. Men are very comfortable with getting picked up, paying no gas money. That's, no, I can't. And then on top of that, this, the dating game is so whack. The single life, the hookup culture is over. It's kind of like whack and over with, because, you know, it's not the STDs that I'm worried about. It's the soul ties that I'm worried about. Because, trust me, soul ties are real. They are real. If you don't think they're real, look at Krishan Rock. She has a soul tie. A soul tie is much worse than an STD. You can take something and get rid of the STD. And for the STDs you can't take and get rid of, I'm pretty sure there's a benefit of some sort that you can take. But still, a soul tie, honey? Huh. It's not nice. It's not nice. It's not nice to be in a position to where you're having a connection with someone, you think you're having that connection with someone, and boom, they're gone. They're just gone. Or, you know, you have that connection with someone that's toxic and does not feel the same way about you. I sit back and I ask myself sometimes, what would it be like if guys, I mean, like, boys, if they were, like, completely honest about them being boys, you know, even after over.
Long time no see.
So is today boy day?
Well, I've been seeing how great your life has been on Instagram, and I've been missing out on it because I'm not a woman to make things work.
So you see, I'm living my life on Instagram. You want to come back into my life because you dicked me down 6 months ago and you got ghosts and...
Not necessarily. It's more like ripping the benefits of what you got going on and trying to see if it aligns with my life and elevates me.
But you dick me down, then you just disappear. You don't see anything wrong with that?
Well, I never see it that way. It's almost like I only cared about myself in that whole situation. Like, I care about you, but I don't care about how it makes you feel.
Why you had to say that right here? I mean, what's changed now?
I have to put on this persona that I'm a changed man, but I'm really the same person that you left months ago. And then if you're comfortable, I'm just going to take until I feel better about myself, and then use whatever you have going on and apply that to my life. I'll strip you of that piece that you once had. I'm going to leave. Again.
So if you're watching this and you suffer from main character syndrome like I do, this is the part where the girl is supposed to rejoice and so supposed to have this self-esteem and tell the guy how she really feels and that her self-esteem is worth so much more.
You're not that girl! Then,
once again, you're ruining my moment. Like that. Oh my god. Once again.
Honey, you're not the girl in the pictures!
This is my moment.
You're not even the girl next to the girl in the picture.
I am that girl.
You better get what you can get, mama.
You know, you really know how to bring...
Dick is on a scarcity.
You know, just forget it. Forget it. Ugh.
Get it
you just
you
know
can.
How to ruin a fantasy. This
you
is supposed to be my fantasy.
Again.
This is supposed to be my make-believe. This is not even real. I don't even know this dude.
Oh, well. What
this is supposed
say?
To be my fantasy,
you
and you ruined it.
Some. In your case, you lose a bit more than you win. A lot more than you win, actually.
You know, that is so sad. Even within my own fantasy, I can't get out of my own way. Let me tell you something. I may not be a lot of things, but one thing I am is I'm very self-aware. One thing I think that I'm pretty well at is taking accountability. And even though I may say I'm going to go live or I'm gonna release a video this evening or so, and it does not happen, I want you to know that with every fiber of my being, it's trying to happen, but I can only do so much. I do apologize to everyone that have kept waiting. I know your time is busy and things of that nature. And yeah, I do get in my own way. And there is no excuse for that. What I am doing and what I am going to make a conscious effort of doing is try to start, go with being more consistent. Because I always say to myself, like, who am I? I mean, how dare me, you know, want a consistent anything in my life. I mean, even from a consistent boyfriend to a consistent, when I can't even consistently, you know, give you guys episodes every other month or every week. And you guys can stay on me. I appreciate that. Even when you read me for filth. Because I know sometimes tough love is hard, but it needs to be said. And I know some of you are just reading for filth because you see me as being the filth. And I know some of you all are just coming to read me. Just that. You're just coming to read me. Anyways, I am starting to believe and I'm starting to take accountability even more so. And just like the great, late, great Michael Jackson himself said, it starts with the man in the mirror. Yeah, it's, oh. See, this, you know what? You'll see me next week. Y'all know what I mean. For those who waited, I thank you for staying with me for the long haul. Please remember to always subscribe, share, and like. And I don't take your love for granted. But most importantly, live for you and live freely.